took years.
Going back to what you were saying about the fact that you've got Keane on one and Lockhart on the other, if you look at some of the previous games by Ennis, it's understandable why they might go up the middle. We're going to take a short break here. That's the end of the first quarter with the Ennis Lions leading 12-3 over the Canutillo Eagles.
Welcome back to Lubbock. Louis Del Rio here alongside Rick Cabrera. So beginning of the second quarter, it's 12-3 Lions. Rick, what have you seen so far that's had to score here with the Lions on top?
The Lions seem to be taking advantage of their size on the outside and for the most part their quickness with the backfield and Thompson, both Thompsons really. But we'll see what happens on this first drive of the second quarter. Around the left end, it's their big running back, number one. And Trey Elliott, as we mentioned earlier, had missed most of the last couple of games with an injury. Looks that's some of the better running we've seen from him in quite some time. Elliott has been struggling a little bit with an injury. It'll bring up a second and seven for the Lions here from the 36-yard line.
All year long, they've been going to Elliott and Thompson. Looks like they're kind of easing Elliott into the offense. They're having Thompson really take those screen passes and those swing passes out of the backfield. Looks like now Elliott seems to have his legs under him, and looks like he's going to be part of the offense here in the second quarter.
Jumping back to pass. The Ennis Lions looking for a big 6'6" Thompson, and he does get the catch.
Devin Smith.
It's short of a first down, though. We'll bring 11, up a third down Thompson. For the Lions.
Way to get position there, not allowing him to get any more yards after the catch, but good defense. They knew where the ball was going.
2 yards
but, of course,
play.
I mean, I don't even know how you stop that, Rick.
I don't know either when you're that tall, but as a defense coordinator, you'll take those short gains on first and second down if you can get the stop on third down. Third and four here from the 39-yard line. Big play here for the Eagles. They want to get that ball back, get some offense continuity going. And it's a handoff to Elliott and tackled behind the line of scrimmage for just a short gain.
Unbelievable play right there by Frank Gutierrez. Nice play, the way to get to the ball. And this is, again, what they continue to do all year long. Now fourth and four, force them to punt. And again, back in a situation where if they can get a play and make a play here, they're right back in this game.
Back deep to receive for the Eagles. Number 17, Ben Galvez.
Brandon Martinique, their kicker, is also their punter.
Number 34, Brandon Martinique.
Ben Galvez back to receive for the Lions. And it's a fake punt up the gut, but nothing going on. The Eagles sniff it out, and they're going to have great field position at the 41-yard line. An aggressive call by Coach Jack Oliver this early in the game.
Aggressive call, but you have to kind of question that call. It's only 12-3. Canutillo can still get into this game. It seems as if maybe they wanted to clamp down here in the second quarter. But now a big, big play for the Eagles, and again, another big special teams play. They were on their toes. They were ready for it. They were not lax. They weren't kind of just relaxing on the play, and there you go. Now they have some great field position here at the Lions' 42-yard line.
The ball snapped
47-yard line.
Up man on that punt, but he's unable to get the first down. Sets up a first down again, like you said, from the 42-yard line. Javier Gomez under. Hands it off to Andrew Alarcón up the middle. Actually, that's Joe Gutierrez who takes it. And that time up the gut definitely did work for the Eagles.
That's right. And Joe has four touchdowns on the year, 561 yards on the ground. And there you go. They've been doing it. And maybe they're beating down those tackles in the middle. They've been trying to go up the middle, And there you go. They pick up 7 yards right there. Let's see what they can do here on second and three.
Javier Gomez in the shotgun. And it's a quarterback keeper up the middle. Again, continue to pound the middle of that Ennis defense. It looks like it's going to be close to a first down. Not quite there, though. It looks like he's about a half a yard short of the first down.
Keandre Flowers.
Just a little short. It looks like it's going to be third and one here.
He just followed Joe Gutierrez right up the middle.
Maybe some time for a little Ben Galavis. Are they going to bring him into the game?
Third down and one for the Eagles.
This is third down and one from the 33-yard line.
They're going to go four receiver set here. Can't imagine they're going to throw it on third and one.
And it's another keeper for Gomez who almost breaks it. Eventually taken down, but he does have the first down. He's down at the 26-yard line.
And something you have to commend Scott Brooks and the coaching staff for here, they're not going away from their game plan. Clearly their game plan is to go up the middle until they can soften up the tackles. And it didn't work in the first quarter. They didn't let go of their game plan. And now here you go. Now they're moving first and 10 at the 27-yard line.
Again, another spread set for the Eagles. Gomez, again, looking to go up the middle. This time he breaks to the right, shakes a tackler, and is eventually taken down after a short gain. Thought about going to the sideline there and thought better of it and cut back into the field.
And I think that play right there is why they don't go to the outside. They are quick from sideline to sideline, this defense. Look how they never seem to lose composure. They always stay with the ball. I feel like Brooks is going to end and call this one up the middle again. What do you think?
It's certainly possible. And I guess you got to believe at some point they are going to throw the ball. It's not like Gomez didn't ever throw the ball this season. Gomez had 16 passing touchdowns this season. They counted for 34 in total.
Absolutely, 1,400 yards. So he can throw the ball, but no need to right now.
The option pitch. And on the edge, oh, that is a horse collar.
Do we have a flag? Do we have a flag on the field?
There, and that's Ben Galavis, who was tackled from behind.
On the carry.
See this here on the replay. It looks like the horse collar here as he hits the middle, and that is a penalty. That is a horse collar right there. Let's see. No flag on the field. That would have been big right there.
You know, I'm not a high school rep.
Lubbock Independent School District and the Texas Sports Marketing Radio Network wish to thank
call the horse collar foul in the high school ranks. It hasn't trickled down like it has in the pro and college ranks.
Suddenly,
they're going to measure for the first down here.
Fans, don't forget to visit our concession stands located at the north end of the stands,
and
where you can enjoy a
first down for the Eagles at the 23-yard line, make it the 21.
Restrooms are available for your convenience.
And as I said, as the second set of downs started, I thought maybe it'd be Ben Galavis' time to get him in and use his wheels. And there you go. We had the play there. Now he's set in the backfield with Gomez. We assume a read option to come. And why don't they use a speedy Galavis one more time?
He's also happy to have Sivan Guillen back after missing some games with an injury. He's on the right side of your screen, just outside the picture. Gomez keeps it. Fakes the handoff to Galavis. Doesn't get much, though.
Number 10, Javier Gomez.
They'll bring up a second and 10. Make it 9 from the 15-yard line.
Play by number 44.
This drive right now, this was big for the Eagles. The confidence, the composure of this offense. They're moving the ball. Now they can kind of see, hey, our game plan is working. We can move the ball on these guys. And now punching it into the end zone here will be big.
Just about 7.5 minutes left here in the second quarter of the state semifinal showdown. He does give it to Gutierrez, I believe, and he is taken down after a short gain by James Lockhart, the Texas A&M commit right there.
James Lockhart
comes around from his right end spot and makes the tackle in the backfield.
And you have to assume if scouts are in the building, they are salivating. By the way, he just got around a Division I offensive tackle, and the way he brought down that running back before he even reached the line of scrimmage. Unbelievable.
We did mention John Boyd playing left tackle for the Canutillo Eagles. Longtime starter, 27 straight starts with his guard.
First pass.
Looking for the pass into the corner of the end zone. A terrific grab by the Eagles. Gerson Aguilar with a terrific catch. Wow, you knew it was going to come at some point. A terrific grab by number 80, Gerson Aguilar, in the end zone. And just like that, we have a ball game, folks. Eagles. Just an extra point away from cutting the lead to just 2 points with just under 7 minutes to go here in the second quarter in Lubbock.
Just 300 receiving yards for Aguilar throughout the season. This is his fourth touchdown. Unbelievable fade.
You knew at some point they were just going to fall asleep, though, DBs, and it looked like it happened there for Ennis. So now, with 6 minutes and 52 seconds left to play here in the second quarter in Lubbock, it's the Ennis Lions 12, your Canutillo Eagles 10. Lowry Field, the momentum has certainly changed now in the Eagles' favor after that failed attempt at the fake punt by Jack Alvarez, and the Ennis Lions now kicking off Frank Avila for the Eagles, now just trailing by 2 points. It's D. Wilson taking the kickoff back. There is a little bit of a hole there. It closes quickly, though, and he's taken out at the 28-yard line. Actually, one of the better jobs of cover to kickoff by the Eagles today.
So 12-10 now to get back to that pass. How about a great way to complete your first pass of the game, then a beautiful 20-yard fade into the corner. I tell you, you would think that he threw the ball 20 times, 30 times a game with that pass. Scott Brooks might be changing his game plan here.
If you're only complete one out of every three passes and it's for a touchdown, any coach will take that.
Unbelievable pass.
Kicking team.
Illegal formation on the Eagles. That'll move the ball up 5 yards as the Lions get ready to take possession. 6 minutes and 44 seconds left here in the second quarter.
Something, obviously the touchdown is why we play the game for touchdowns, but another key component of that drive was keeping the defense off the field. The defense seemed to have gotten at least in actual time about 20 minutes of rest.
First down.
So there you go, the official call. It's declined, first down here for the Lions. But getting back to that, it gave this defense some sort of a rest to compose, find themselves, take a breather. Now they can come out here and get ready and try and stop this Lions offense.
So after declining the penalty, it'll be a first down and 10 for the Ennis Lions at the 35-yard line. You have to wonder about that decision to go for the fake punt on their own side of the field with the strong 12-3 lead at that point.
You know, Rick, we spoke about it during the break. It just seemed like it was too early of a time to do that. State semifinal game, it's a close game. You're inside your own territory. You know, punt it away. Canutillo didn't really show that they could move the ball on them too effectively anyway, and it seemed like you kind of put them in position to score. You let them gain that confidence, and now they have themselves a 12-10 ball game.
Finally got things figured out. It's going to be a first and 10 from the 28-yard line here for Ennis. Devin Smith dropping back to pass. He's looking downfield. There was some contact before the pass, but no flags on the field. It'll be second and 10 for the Lions.
Devin Smith's pass intended for number 11, Dante Thompson.
So 12-10, Canutillo looking good in this game. Of course, trying to become the first ever El Paso school to reach a state title game.
The temperature is dropping a little bit here in Lubbock at Lowry Field. Beautiful stadium. Again, thank you to the Lubbock ISD for making this possible. I want to thank our sponsors, Applebee's and El Paso Community College, for making this unprecedented broadcast available to you at home in El Paso. Off the right end, it's Taylor Thompson. He slips free, gets about 8 yards on the run off of the right end.
Dubbed by number 11, Bo Brooks.
Canutillo just got a shoestring tackle there. Looked like he was going for some more yards.
I have really been impressed with Taylor Thompson's quickness, both on the swing pass and out of the backfield as well.
Gained 9 yards.
We've got third and one here, maybe a third and one and a half for the Lions. Again, it's Devin Smith under center for them. The handoff. And it's Thompson just barely getting by as he does get the first down, though. Picks him about 4 yards on the short run. This time trying the left side of that Canutillo defense, or going around the left side of his offensive line.
Again, Gutierrez with the shoestring tackle twice, where it looked like Thompson was ready to break away. Canutillo just gets that hand out and stops momentum. But first and 10 here for the Lions.
Coach Brooks did tell us he was happy about the fact that Ennis is a more traditional. They are balanced, but they do like to run the ball out of a normal set. None of this five wide spread you out kind of thing.
Absolutely. But you got the guy 6'6 on the outside. You can go to him anytime.
That's the one receiver right. You do want out there. Looking for him right there. Azoff on cue, and it's a 9-yard pickup to Thompson.
Peter Torres all over that one right there. Still yardage for the Lions. Nice throw.
Tackle on the play by
the quarterback there.
Peter Torres
found his spot in the pocket, moved out of way, found a lane, and delivered it to his big 6'6" receiver. We were down on the field before the game. He is definitely 6'6" too.
Absolutely, and
because he only had me like an inch or two.
Yeah, right. he looks like a big time athlete.
Second and two from the 50-yard line for the Ennis Lions. Jumping back to pass is Smith. He's looking deep for his big guy Thompson. It's underthrown, but it doesn't matter. He makes the play. He grabs it, still on his feet, finally taken down inside the 20-yard line. A big, big 30-yard pitch and catch for the Lions, who are now have something cooking at the 20-yard line.
On a play like this, and we're going to watch it here on the replay, you don't need coaches, you don't need uniforms, you don't need rules, you don't need anything. All you need right there is someone who is taller than somebody else. I mean, you're in the backyard just throwing up the ball right there. and they made the play.
You can't really fault Roger Soto, though. He made a great play on that. Just couldn't quite rip it away on that underthrown ball. A quick timeout on the field. We'll take a break here from Lowry Field at Plains Capital Park with a score of the Lions 12, the Eagles 10. We pick it up here with 4 minutes and 25 seconds left to go. It's a 2nd and 5 for the Lions. Ball on the 15-yard line after a short run by Taylor Thompson. The swing out to the side. He's looking for a spot, tries to juke, but it's not going to happen as the Eagles' swarming defense does its job there on 2nd down.
So now 3rd and short for the Lions. Again, this defense find themselves in a 3rd and short. Time to set it. Or 3rd and 6, so lost a couple yards there. This is what they need. They need something to get someone, maybe force this kid to kick a field goal here, and we know how he is.
Again, welcome back to Lowry Field in Lubbock. So glad we can be bringing this unprecedented live coverage from Lubbock. ABC7 very proud to be bringing you this game. On 3rd down, they drop back the pass. Look out from behind. He's stripped of the ball. The ball is loose. Canutillo picks it up, and they're on the run. It is Trey Elliott trying to make the tackle, but eventually after the 50-yard line, it's number 20 with a nice-looking pickup, but what an incredible play on the backside. Devin Smith didn't see what was coming, and the Eagles were coming in a hurry.
Merry Christmas to Solomon Orozco. He just says, hey, here we go. Here's the ball. And that, you see, this is what they've been doing all year. Frank Gutierrez on the outside finds himself wide open, the quarterback at his blind side. Fumble, force fumble, the pickup, and now they are in business. This is what this defense has been doing all year. Again, coach said offense kind of struggles, but the defense Roscoe's always gives us that return. Pulse and some of that life. And here we go right here. The Eagles at midfield trying to take the lead.
Fantastic play by Gutierrez.
After the play.
Ripping that ball.
Unsportsmanlike. Number 11, defense. Number 11, offense. Those penalties are going to offset. First down, Canutillo.
That's Donta Thompson with the unsportsmanlike conduct, along with Bo Brooks, the safety for the Eagles. So the two penalties nullify each other, and the Eagles have a 1st down inside Ennis territory. Stepping up and finding through the hands of Savon Guillen, who'd been out with an injury. Coach was excited to have him back this week. Coach Brooks of Canutillo, but that ball went right through his hands. Nice looking throw by Gomez. You got to make that catch.
That's unfortunate there. That looked like that could have been a big play, but maybe, as we said, he has been out. Maybe a little rust there between the quarterback and receiver, but that looked like that could have been a 1st down right there, right off the bat.
We've got 3 minutes and 28 seconds to go here in the 2nd quarter. The Eagles trail by 2 to the Ennis Lions. The handoff up the middle. Stood up after about a 5-yard gain. Andrew Alagoan. Looks like they're trying to strip the ball from. Things are getting a little chippy out there. Some pushing and shoving. Refs trying to get involved. Break things up.
And I guess that's what Scott Brooks is talking about, that Canutillo football, huh? They're going to fight to the end. He's not going to let anybody push him around.
He did say they have a chip on their shoulder, no doubt about it.
Gain of 5 yards on the play.
So gain of 5 there. 3rd and 5.
Ennis, 43-yard line.
A big 3rd down for the Eagles and for the Lions defense. They want to get a stop right here and get the ball back with about 2 minutes to go here in the 2nd quarter. And the
timeout.
Eagles call a
Canutillo.
Timeout. But 2:41 to go here in the 2nd quarter. The Lions lead 12-10.
It seems to be a great time for a timeout here. 2:41. You're on a crossroad there. 3rd and 5. Now you have to decide, okay, what are we going to do? We're going to bring our running back out of the backfield. We're going to go up the middle and continue. Maybe pass the ball. We saw the success they had on that 3rd down pass the last time. So okay, this is a very pivotal play right here.
Certainly, and when you look at the Lions, they have played some really good defense in spurts, but it's that middle of the defense that's starting to show some weakness. So if you're Coach Brooks, you're really debating, am I going up the gut again? Do I believe my offense to get me 5 yards up the middle, or am I going to do something on the outside? Again, we just saw that pass to Savon Guillen. It was almost there. Ben Galavis also has some speed, so he's got some options here. Maybe an end around is an option as well.
As we said, the receiver has been out, so maybe a little bit of rust, but that pass was on point. That would have been big, but hey, we're here. 3rd and 5 is the play, 2:41. To go in the half, and I guess we can say here the biggest play of the game right now for the Eagles.
Without a doubt, because you don't want to, the flip side of things, give the Lions a lot of time to maybe get a drive going before the end of the 1st half on their side of things.
3rd down.
3rd and 5 from the 43-yard line. Gomez alone in the backfield, rolling to his left. He's looking for his wide receiver. Too high and too tall and out of bounds. And they are now going to have to punt the ball here as we wind down in the second quarter. Didn't really give himself a lot of options. That was a one-receiver route.
You know, and when you watch that play there, that's a one-on-one. He's in the corner. I'm sure Gomez will like that pass back there. I think they should have stuck there with the run up the middle, or at least have a running back come out of the backfield. That seemed to be uncharacteristic of a play call for the Eagles.
He may have rushed that throw just a little bit. Here's John Luna on to punt.
And they can get
Caleb
that.
Thompson decides to let it bounce.
He's got to get on that.
And it rolls into the end zone. So they'll have a ball at the 20-yard line with 2 minutes and 22 seconds Luna left here in the second quarter. I'll tell you what, Louie, as we approach halftime, this has been an entertaining game without a doubt.
Absolutely. This game is exactly
first
what
down 10
at least
Scott
Brooks expected. The fans back at home expected a nice low-scoring game, 12-10. The defense doing exactly what it's doing now. The running game starting to establish itself, but we knew this team had playmakers. They score points, but only 12 points right now, so Scott Brooks has to be happy right now, but this drive is gonna mean something.
Tough defense, opportunistic offense, and it's paying off so far. Again, but it is the Lions with that lead, and now they have the ball. First and 10 from the 20-yard line with 2 minutes and 22 seconds left here in the first half. Devin Smith decides to run it. He's got an opening, slips a tackle, shakes one of the defenders out. He's still on his feet down at the 42-yard line. A 22-yard gain for the speedy quarterback, Devin Smith.
Nice play right there. That was just a keeper right up the middle using his athleticism.
Juke here, slips the tackle.
Gained 22 yards.
Anthony Minaz, one of the lead tacklers for Canutillo, had a shot at him there.
He's going to have to go find his ankles.
First down here. Drop it back to pass. They're still looking to pass. Oh, now he's going to keep it. He gets the end. Is he going to go out of bounds? Yes. He steps out of bounds after a short gain, about 3 yards there.
Even there, seemed like a broken play, but still picked up yards and stopped the clock.
You get the sense with the Ennis offense that Devin Smith is going to drop back, look for Thompson, and if Thompson isn't there, he's probably going to run it.
3 yards on the play. Second down and 7.
This time it's Trey Elliott who comes out to the left side of your screen, and it's Thompson lined up as a tight end. The slip screen is there. Thompson shakes a couple of tackles and shakes a couple of defenders, I should say, before he gets tackled at the 41-yard line. That's another first down for the Lions, who are now moving the ball. Another two big completions, two big gains.
Another first down, and extremely frustrating for this defense. You get to the quarterback, you get to the backfield where you feel like you're going to make a play and stop his momentum, and he finds a way to dump the ball off, and they pick up the first down.
Time running down, 1:50 to go. The throw to Thompson, who gets it. It's about a 6-yard gain there for the Lions.
Pass complete to number 11.
Clock continues to run.
Coverage on the play by number 15.
At this point for Ennis, impeccable clock management, impeccable play calling here to keep the clock going and have a shot here at the end zone.
One of the Lions coaches very upset seeing that clock continue to run. They do have 3 timeouts. Looks like the referees are going to discuss things. One of the coaches for Ennis clearly upset out on the field and kept waving and pointing.
With the clock operator, put 1:31 on the clock, please.
Time is pivotal right now as we go into the half.
We are joining you live from beautiful Plains Capital Park in Lubbock. Somewhat of a breezy night, but you know what? I got the sense those Canutillo fans weren't complaining, Louie, because it gave them a chance to wear those really sweet hoodies they were wearing. We went over to the other side and met up with some of the fans before the game.
I know we don't need any in here, but I would still like one.
First down, the run, and it's Thompson again. He's really been a star in this first half, and this time he gets it inside the 20-yard line, pushed out of bounds around the 17. And the clock stops with 1:25 to go.
Now this Lions offense is just kind of making this look easy now. Now they're just using their playmakers. They're just moving the ball, and they seem to find every hole, every seam on the outside, on the inside. And they're just picking up chunks of yardage, and they have themselves another first down.
Ball on the 17-yard line. Thompson spreads out to the right. His cousin, Taylor Thompson on the left. Dropping back to pass. He's looking toward the end zone. It's going to be a jump ball, and Thompson brings it in. It is another touchdown for the Lions. A nice-looking pitch and catch. Well done, Thompson, again, 6 foot six. Hard to defend that.
Well, he just threw up the Dez Bryant X, and we've seen Dez Bryant do that many times. And he's a little bit bigger than Dez Bryant at 6'6". Unfortunately, there's no analysis for that. You can't stop that. He just throws it up. He wasn't even in position for the ball. The ball was kind of thrown behind him and away from him. And he just went up, used his 6'6 frame and his athleticism, pulled it in. And now a nice little cushion here for Ennis.
After two missed extra points, this time they'll go ahead and run it, go for the two-point conversion. It's the pitch to Thompson, who's going to basically get into the end zone for the two-point conversion.
Number three, Taylor Thompson goes in for the two-point conversion.
So now 20-0 here, Ennis. They got at least two of those points back on the missed extra points. So now 20-0 with a minute 17 to go.
10.
Or 20-10. Sorry.
We don't want to scare
Eagle fans
at home.
I took my glasses off. Sorry. So 20-10, minute 17 to go. We'll be right back after a break.
Number 17,
there is the kickoff by Brandon Martinique, taken by the Eagles at the 15-yard line. Trying to come around the other side is Caleb Cosio, but nothing doing as he's taken down at the 20-yard line. You got to wonder here because the Lions do play some pretty good defense. The Eagles are traditionally a run-first offense. With a minute 11 to go, will Coach Brooks try to get some more points, trailing by 10, or will he be content to go down to the break, maybe do a couple of runs and see what happens?
At this point, I don't think you can waste any possessions here. Minute 11 to go. We have timeouts for them. As one timeout, you might as well use it. Try and get something here. Move it up. Don't get too crazy. Be sort of conservative. Stick to your game plan. But you can't waste possession here with a minute to go.
Maybe a high percentage pass for Gomez. We'll see what happens on first down. He does give it the handoff up the middle between the tackles. Joe Gutierrez goes up the middle, but not much cooking there.
Ennis
actually decides to call the timeout. Maybe believing the momentum is on their side, and they get one more possession before the half.
That touchdown and then the way they stopped Cosio right there on the kickoff return, momentum is definitely on Ennis' side, and it's showing right now.
We spoke with Coach Jack Alvarez this week, and he said he's got 32 seniors. They're high-character guys. They were here last year. They want to get back there. They lost to Alito, the eventual state champions. But he said he's got a good team, and they win all kinds of ways. I asked him, do you guys win with offense, do you win with defense? He goes, sometimes we've had to outscore teams. Sometimes we've had to play some hard-nosed, tough-fought games where it's a low-scoring game. So he has a little bit of both. What's interesting is both teams average about 40 points a game, but when you look at what they give up on the defensive side of the ball, the Eagles have been a much better defense this year.
Well, as you said, they're both averaging 40 points, but they do it in different ways here. Obviously, they're both run first, but as you can watch on the Canutillo side, they really don't have that one playmaker where they know they can go to and have a play happen. Unfortunately, with Ennis, they do. With Thompson, where they know they can just go ahead and throw it up and see what happens, at least maybe get a pass interference call. Canutillo seems to be lacking that player right now on offense.
Let's go back to the action. Again, the Lions will probably need to get a first down if they want to keep Ennis from using their timeouts. And it's Gomez keeping it around the left end. He's got some speed. He's got some distance. He's got it to the 40, to the 20, 35. Knocked out of bounds at the 32-yard line.
And speaking
first time
of,
he got the edge.
I say, speaking of that lack of player, Gomez reminded me that he has over 2,500 all-purpose yards. He says, no, I'm that guy for this team. And he breaks off a beautiful run. Let's see if Gomez can continue this here as the clock is now sitting at 55 seconds.
There is a flag on the play. Came out near the tackle. Let's see what the call is. 55 seconds to go here. Gomez did get out of bounds after getting the big chunky yardage there.
What a play there. This is what they needed here. 55 seconds to go. And this is how we said when I mentioned when this drive started. You cannot waste possessions, especially running the ball. Anything can happen. You can find the seam. But let's hear the call here on the field. Scott Brooks is ready to put on the pads, Rick.
We had the pleasure to see him this week, and it was great to see how excited he was. And he understands the importance of a game like this. This really is history, and he grew up in the El Paso area. His dad coached there. He's got family.
After the play.
Unsportsmanlike. Defense. Number. Pushing off the runner. Dino. First down.
A costly, costly penalty for the Lions.
The Canutillo fans back home can send the Ennis head coach a thank you note for calling that timeout and helping Canutillo to set up a nice play call here. So here we go.
They've got a first and 10 from the 18-yard line. 55 seconds to go here in the second quarter of this state semifinal game. This is the Class 5A Division II state semifinal. The winner will move on to the state championship game next week to play the winner of tonight's game in Austin between Crosby and Cedar Park.
Couldn't have asked for a better game here tonight.
They keep it with Alatcon. He may have lost the ball. Looks like there was a fight for the ball toward the end of the play.
But it looks like right there they did recover. Jonathan Luna seemed to have jumped on that ball immediately to keep it, but he definitely had that ball ripped out of his hands for a second.
That was a close call for
number two, Jonathan Luna.
There you see it coming out of Alakon's hands, but watch Luna, Johnny on the spot, literally. Jonathan Luna, Johnny on the spot.
How many Johnny?
Here we go, the run. This time it's Gomez keeping it. Able to break one tackle, but that's it. We got 30 seconds left. They have just one timeout. Will they use it here?
Tackle on the play by number five.
And it seems to be getting their hands in there. Gomez looked like he was almost stripped.
On third and three, they choose not to use the timeout.
Gain of 2 yards on the play. Third and three.
15 seconds to go here in the first half. Not really sure of the play. It looks like it was a wheel route, but no one's there for the Eagles, who will probably have to settle for a field goal here, a short one at that, with just 9 seconds to go. Fourth and three from the 11-yard line.
And again, another pivotal play here for the Eagles. And again, they go to the pass. The run has continued to get them to this point, and then they abandon it and go to a pass.
Fourth down and three for the Eagles.
At this point, you've moved the ball. You're at the 11. It's fourth and three. There's 9 seconds to go.
Frank Avila with the 28-yard field goal attempt. And he splits the uprights, makes it 20-13. Lions on top with just 4 seconds to go.
Kid is automatic. That leg is automatic. So there you go, 20-13. Ennis is up with 4 seconds to go. You could not ask for a better game right here with Ennis and Canutillo here in the Class 5A Division II semifinal game.
Not as low scoring as Coach Brooks would have hoped. He was hoping maybe a 10-7 game at the break, but so far so good.
20-13 seems just fine with the way Ennis has been moving the ball.
Richie's singing career began with a student at Coronado. Dare to dream. Richie credits his teachers for providing the inspiration to dream big and to always give his best.
My story?
Beginning right here.
So 20-13, 4 seconds to go in the half. We're still here with you. Thank you for joining us in Lubbock. Louis Del Rio here with Rick Cabrera. 20-13 here in this game. 4 seconds to go. Field goal made by Canutillo. Field goals. That is something they've done. They're on special teams. They kick their field goals. They keep themselves in the game right here. Assume that they're going to kick it away from the returners here.
Really the difference at this point, the Eagles have had to settle for two field goals while the Lions have got those big touchdowns to big Donta Thompson.
I was going to say, I think the difference here is Donta Thompson. I think no analysis needed. It's Donta Thompson at this point. You throw it up to him. If they didn't have him to throw it up to, Canutillo might have the lead in this game.
On to kick for the Eagles. Number 45, Jonathan Ochoa.
Jonathan Ochoa will kick it off for the Eagles.
Speaking with Scott Brooks all week, as we said, he did want a low-scoring game, but if it's 20-13 going into the half, and Canutillo really hasn't played a game as well as maybe they've played all year, he has to be thrilled.
And there is the kickoff with 4 seconds left to go. It's a squib kick dropped by the Lions, picked up. He's trying to find somewhere to run. This is Thompson, one of their speedier backs. He's had a great game too, the cousin of Donta Thompson.
Taylor
and that ends the first half of the game. From here at Plains Capital Park, we've got